So, Tanishka and Sadhana, in the previous class, we were studying a very important chapter that is trigonometry, and we were doing some important topics, okay, related to that one. So, let me open that slide first. So, here it is, trigonometry. So is my screen is visible to you now?
So
Okay. Yes. So let's study. So in the previous class, we were studying about the trigonometry, and I have discussed that sometimes we get different kinds of problems related to trigonometries, and we need to solve that type of problems. Okay. And generally, the student face we need to solve such type of means. We need four to five types of questions. We need to solve four to five types of questions, and all the questions will be related to these. They are those types. Okay. So in the previous class, we were discussing about the trigonometry, and I have taught you that like this way. Let me give you the examples here. Okay. So let's understand. Yes, Sadhana. So I have told you that we in the previous class there are some quantities, there are some physical quant sorry, not of the physical quantity, they are mathematical quantities. Okay, like we have sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, and these are the trigonometric terms actually. Okay, and this is sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, sec theta, cot theta, and cosec theta. And I have taught you that we need to learn only sine, cos, tan, and others are the reciprocal of these. Others will be the reciprocal of these. For example, if I'm saying that sine theta, so sine theta is the reciprocal of cosec theta. Cos, and you knew that the cos start with C and the sec end with C. So this is the reciprocal of this one to keep in mind to learn it. Okay, and T, the tan start with T and cot ends with T. So here tan is the reciprocal of cot. And we have these terms that if we have the terms like sine theta. Okay, we have the sine theta. The sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, and this one is base. So sine theta is this one upon this one. This is sine theta. Okay, this one upon this one. Cos theta is this one upon this one, means base upon hypotenuse. And tan theta is actually perpendicular upon base. So this is actually the tan theta, this is cos theta, and this one is sine theta. Okay. So you need to keep in mind here that we can memorize this one by using PBP. That's have a mnemonics that we used to study in the when I was in 10th standard, like Pakistan Bhooka Pyaasa Hindustan Hara Bhara. And there are so many mnemonics, and no need to just this is a kids mnemonics that I was in 10th standard and I used to learn this one. So you need to keep this one, or you can use another mnemonics also. So this one is P upon H means perpendicular upon hypotenuse, not the height. Keep in mind this is a hypotenuse. A P is perpendicular, not the height. The perpendicular upon hypotenuse is actually the value of sine. Base upon hypotenuse is the value of cos, and perpendicular upon base is the value of tan. Got it? Do you have any doubt regarding to this one?
No, sir.
Okay. In a similar way, if the reciprocal, if I'm saying tan theta is 1 upon cot theta, and that will be equivalent to tan theta is 1 upon cot theta, that will be equivalent to P upon perpendicular upon base. Okay. So what will be the value of cot theta? The cot theta will be equivalent to base upon perpendicular. Okay. So this is the reciprocal. If I'm saying cos theta is equals to base upon hypotenuse, so sec theta will be hypotenuse upon base. Okay, that we have studied. And in the previous class, I have also discussed that we have some specific values of sine. The value of sine started from 0 and ends its 1. From 0 to 90, the value of sine increases. Means if we have the value of sine, the from 0 to 1 means sine, the value of sine is directly proportional to the theta from 0 to 1. from 0 to 1, the value of sine is directly proportional. Okay, so you need to keep in mind here that the graph of sine that I have taught you in the previous class, like we were discussing the graph of sine. Where's the graph of sine? Okay, here. Taught you the graph of sine. Where's the graph of sine? Okay, I was teaching you here, the graph of sine, I was teaching you here that the graph of sine started from here. Sine 0 is 0, and up to the 90, it has a maximum value of 9. And it is like this one. It is like this one. So we have the values up to 90. So no need to memorize or learn it further above 90, after the 90. Okay, but you need to keep in mind that at sine 0 is 0, at sine 180 is also 0. Okay. And moreover, I taught you that this is the graph for the cos. This is the graph for the cos, and it starts from 1. When the cos is 0, when we have the theta is 0, it is going to have the value 1. It is going to have the value 1. The cos 0 is 1, and cos 90 is 0. And from these sine and cos, we can, if we know the value of sine and cos, then we can find out the value of other trigonometric ratios also. No need to learn the values of 10 also. Because if we have that, if we know that's the value of sine 30, okay, if I'm saying that is sine 30, okay, so sine 30 means if the angle is, if theta is the angle, let's suppose I'm saying that theta is equals to 30 degree, okay, what will be the value of 10-30? If you don't know the value of 10-30, let it be. But you need to keep in mind that you need to memorize the value of 10 sine 30 and cos 30. If these two values you know, the value of sine 30 and cos 30, 10-30 you can predict. Easily you can predict. Because you know that 10-30 means tan theta is equals to sine theta upon cos theta. This is an identity, or you can say that it's a relation between, we can represent the sine in terms of cos and cot. And how can we say this one? Because you know that the value of sine theta is actually perpendicular upon hypotenuse, and that of cos theta is actually base upon hypotenuse. This hypotenuse and hypotenuse will cancel out, and this will give to P upon B, and that is equals to tan theta. So tan theta is equals to perpendicular upon base, that I have taught you, that I have discussed. So this means you can simply write it sine theta upon cos theta is equals to tan theta. Okay, got it? Or still having some doubt?
Got it, sir.
Got it. And Tanishka, I think Sadhna. Okay, so Tanishka and Sadhna was saying something that the lecture that you have missed, you can visit to our YouTube channel, that is Learning View. There you can find the every lecture that we studied. If you missed that one, then you can find the recorded lecture there. Okay, so you can visit to that one and you can find there. Okay, the coordinate geometry lecture. How are you, Bright Biju? You were not in the previous class. Where were you? How your exam was going on? Biju, are you there in the class? Is I'm audible to you?
Yes, sir.
I'm asking, beta, how was your exam? You were preparing for the exam?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm just talking about the trigonometry chapter. Today's the mathematics class, actually. Okay, so this chapter is actually very, very easy. The student used to think that it is a tough chapter, but it is not so. It is not so. Understood, Sadhna and Tanishka and Viju, that is not so. You need to understand the concept. And when I teach the student, I don't go to the book first. I only teach you the concept first. Then I will go to the bookish questions. And I usually teach the students. The first I teach the concept. And I usually teach what not to do. While solving a problem, what not to do. If you did this step, if you take this step, then you will find some error. You will go some, okay. So this is my art of teaching, that whenever I'm teaching you, I'm going to clear a concept, and then I will teach you that where you are not going to do this. That means I usually teach that don'ts, means you are not going to do this one. If you do this one, you will be, the most of the chances will be that you will be going to commit the mistake. So let's move further. Okay, let's move further. So this one is cos theta. So cos 0 is 1, cos 90 is 1. If you have the value of tan theta, you don't know the value of tan theta, but you know the value of sine 30. Okay, and you don't know, you know the value of cos 30. So you can predict the value of cos 10 30 also, because you know that the value of 10 sine 30 is actually half, and that of cos 30 is root 3/2. You can cut it and you will get 1/3. You can get 1/3. The value of 10 30 would be 1/3. Got it? How we get this value?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So let's move further. Okay, we have done this one. And let's move further. The calculation of trigonometric identities, that's means that one type of questions that comes in examination will be, they will give you that sine theta, the value of sine theta is this and this. Okay. And they will ask you that in the question, it is being asked that find the other trigonometric ratios, or they will say that what will the value of tan theta if it is being said to you that let's suppose if I'm going to give you a question here that that if sine theta in a question, it is being given that it is 13 by 12. Okay, 13 by 12. Then it may be asked that what would be the value of 10 square theta plus 1. What will be the value of 10 square theta plus 1? Or it may be asked, means they can ask you anything. They may ask you the value of 10 theta, the value of 10 theta. They may ask you the value of sec theta. They may ask you the value of anything they can ask you. Okay. What you need to do here is that, you need to find out the value. Since you know that 13 by 12 is not equal to sine. Means we have studied the value of trigonometric ratio, that the value of sine we have studied from 0, then 30. Then after 30, we have studied 45. Then after 45, we have studied 60. And after 60, we have directly studied the 90. No theta's value in between, we have not studied. We have not studied that one. So we know the value of sine, that is what the value of sine that we know is 0. That is the sine 0 is equals to 0. Then sine 30 is half. Then sine 45 is 1/√2. Then sine 60 is √3/2, and then sine 90 is actually 1. We know only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values of sine theta. But do these values, do 13 upon 12 is a value of sine? Yes, it is a value of sine, but here the theta will not be an accurate value. I mean, it will not be having a value of 0, 30, 45, 60, and 90. It may be in between them, like maybe 32. It may be 32 degree, it may be 40, 47 degree, 49 degree, 88. It can have any value. I don't know. Okay. So if I'm saying that, first of all, you need to predict, is this value, if you find the value of sine, what you need to do is check whether this can be a value, that 13 upon 12 can be a value of sine theta. Can be a value of sine theta. Do you think so? Tell me, Tanishka, Biju, and do you think that can sine theta be equal to 13 upon 12?
No, sir.
Why it can't be?
Sir, hypotenuse is less than.
Because the hypotenuse is
less than
less than
opposite.
Whenever you are solving the problem, and if you find that the value of sine is coming greater than 1, it means you have committed some mistake. You have to check your answer, that whenever you are solving the problem, your answer must not be greater than 1. Because the maximum value of sine is 1. And the value of sine lies between minus 1, 0, and positive 1. The range is from minus 1 to positive 1. You cannot have the value that 1 point something is not possible. So when you divide this one, you will get, when the numerator is greater than denominator, it is going to have the value 1 point something. and you cannot have that value. So it is incorrect, first of all. So what is the correction? That it might be like this, 12 upon 13. Got it? So what we learn here from this one is that when we are solving the problems and we get the value of sine theta or cos theta, including the cos theta also, the maximum value of cos theta and sine theta is positive 1. It cannot be greater than positive 1. So whenever you are solving the problem, keep in mind that your answer must be less than the 1. Okay. So if I'm saying that this is the value of sine theta, 12 upon 13. So 12 upon 13, we have not studied. We don't know the value that which for what value of theta we are going to have this value. So if a simple value is being given to you, like this one is given to you, that sine theta is equals to root 3/2. If it is being given to you, so you can simply write that this one is sine theta is equals to what's the value of 3/2? This is sine 60. And you can simply cut it and you will get theta is equals to 60 degree. So you can simply write theta is equals to 60 degree. So if it is being asked what is the value of 10 theta, you can write here the 1060 will be equals. So if you know the value of 1060, you can easily predict that will be root 3. So you can easily predict out the value of other trigonometry. So if you know the value of theta, okay. But here the theta's value is not actually between, is not a perfect, we can say, is not a 0, 30, 45, 60, and 90. So what we need to do here, tell me, Sadhana, Tanishka, and Biju, what we need to do here, I need to find the value of this one. How can I find the value of this one? Tell me. What we will do, tell me, I'm asking you. Anishka, I'm asking. Biju, tell me, what we will do to proceed the value? How can we get the value of this one? Is I'm audible to you?
Yes, sir.
So how can we proceed? We have to write here that sine theta is equals to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So dear student, you have to write the value that is perpendicular is 12 and hypotenuse is 13. Then find out the value of this one. What would be the value of this one? Calculate the value of this one by using Pythagoras theorem. Tell me. Tell me, Vita, tell me what would be the value. If this is 12, this is 13, then what would be the value of this base? This is simple. You have to give that by the use of Pythagoras theorem. 13 square is equals to 12 square plus base square. So you can write here 13 square is 169, 144 plus base square. So you can write here 169 minus 144 is equals to base square. You will find here 25 is equals to base square. So you can simply write here base is equals to 5. So this is 5. Now, if it is being asked, what is the value of 10 square theta plus 1? What will be the value of 10 square theta plus 1? So you can simply write here that 10 square theta. Okay, you can simply write it like this way. That the value of 10 square theta will be 10 square theta plus 1 will be equivalent to 10 square means you have to write here 10. 10 is 12 upon 5 whole square plus 1. You can simply write here 144 upon 25 plus 1. That will be equivalent to, you have to write here, that is actually a dear student, that will be 5, and that will be 144 plus 25, that will be 169 upon 25. Okay, tell me, what is the value of what is that value, which trigonometric identity is going to have this value 169 upon 25? Tell me, just think, we are just going to have a new formula from this one. Which value this 169 upon 25? Okay, tell me. I'm going to give you a hint. Which trigonometric identity is sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, sec theta, or cot theta? The square of which trigonometric identity is going to have this value? According to this question, the square of which trigonometric identity is going to have this value? Tell me, just think.
So, cosec theta or sec theta?
Sec or cosec? There can be one. There can be one. They cannot be both. Either the sec or the cos. Either the sec theta or the cosec theta. So you know that what is this? This is actually 13 square upon 5 square. 169 is the square of 13. Yeah, cosec. Let's check. So here I'm writing here that it is actually the square of 13 square upon 5 square. Okay, this is the square of 13 upon 5. So it means it is simply the square of hypotenuse upon base square. So if I'm saying that cos is actually this upon this. So reciprocal of cos will be this one. So which one is the, which trigonometric identity is the reciprocal of cos? Which trigonometric identity is the reciprocal of cos?
Sec.
Yes, sec. This is ending with C, this is ending with C. Cosec is also ending with C, but this you need to memorize that cosec is the reciprocal of sine. Okay, so here I'm saying simply that, that it is the square of cosec, sec square theta. So I can simply write here that 10 square theta plus 1 is equals to sec square theta. Got it. You need to keep in mind that this is our first, this is a trigonometric identity that is going to have the value 1 plus 10 square theta is equals to sec square theta. Okay. Now, if I'm asking you what is the value of 1 plus cot square theta? Tell me. According to this problem, what would be the value of 1 plus cot square theta? Tell me. According to this problem, what would be the value of 1 plus cot square theta?
Okay.
The value of actually it is your cot theta is 25 upon 144 plus 1. Okay, cot is the reciprocal of 10. Very good. So what will this value gives you? It will be 144 plus 25 plus 144. LCM, when you take the LCM, is 169 upon 144. Got it? Am I right or wrong?
Yes.
Okay. So tell me, dear student, that which trigonometric identity is going to have this value? The square of which trigonometric identity is going to have this value? According to this question. The square of which trigonometric identity is going to have this value?
Cosec?
Yes, cosec. Because this upon this is the value of cosec. Means the cosec is hypotenuse upon base. Hypotenuse upon perpendicular. So hypotenuse is the square of hypotenuse 13, and this one is the hypotenuse upon perpendicular. So this will be equal to cosec. So this is cosec square theta. So this is our second value. This is our second value. Okay, this is our second value, that 1 plus cot square theta is equals to cosec square theta. And tell me, what would, according to this problem, what would be the value of sine square theta plus cos square theta? According to this problem, what would be the value of sine square theta plus cos square theta?
Equal to 1, sir.
Yes, it will be equal to 1. How we know that? We can simply say that the value of sine square theta here will be 12 square upon 13 square. That will be 144 upon 169 plus the value of cos square theta is actually 5 square upon 13 square. That would be 25 upon 13 square, 169. So when you add this two, you will get 25, we will take the 169 as an LCM, and when 144 added to this 25, we will get 169 again. So that will be equals to 1. So this is our third value. This is our third value. Okay, that will be going to have this questions. Okay, so we have derived the three values from this equation, that 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta, 1 plus sin square theta is equal to sec square theta, and 1 plus sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. Okay, got it, dear student. Please copy these three identities, then we shall be proceeding to the next part. Done?
Yes, sir.
All of you has done?
Yes.
Did you also?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's move further. If I'm saying that, this is A, this is C, this is A, and this one is B. If sine B is equals to 3 upon 4, okay, find the value of sine A upon sine B plus cos B upon cos A. What would be the value of sine A? If I'm saying that the value of sine B is 3 by 4, then what would be the value of sine A upon sine B plus cos B upon cos A? for this equation, for this question, what will be the value of is I'm audible to you clearly?
Yes, sir.
Tell me what is the value of sine A for this equation, for this question. Sadhana, where do you study science?
What, sir?
I'm asking, where do you study science? Are you taking some science classes somewhere else?
No, sir.
No. No, you are not taking that one.
Okay.
Have you calculated the value of sine A?
Sorry, it's 5 by 4. Is it 5 by 4?
5 by 4. Sine A is equals to 5 by 4. Do you think it is a realistic? That's why I have just saying that. This can't be a value. That's why I'm teaching you that where you need not to commit mistake. It is an unrealistic value. The when you solve this one, you will get the answer 1 greater than 1, and it cannot be. It cannot be the value of sine, because the maximum value of sine is 1. Here the answer is more than 1. So it cannot be the value. 5 by 4 is not possible. 4 by 5 can be possible. So let's do, so if I'm saying that this is B, for B, if I'm considering B, this one as B, so this one will be the angle which will be treated as theta B, and you know that the theta angle is made by base and hypotenuse. So for B, this one will be considered as perpendicular. So this one is actually 3 and this one is 4. 3 by 4 is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, the value of sine. Okay. And you can simply calculate the value of, now this one is 3, this one is 4. What will be the value of B? What will be the value of BC? Okay. So if you do this one, this will get B square is equals to 3 square plus X square. So you can simply write here that is 16 minus 9 is equals to X square. If I'm considering this one as X. Okay, so that will be equivalent to how much? That will be equivalent to, you actually don't know the value of this one. That is will be 7. So x will be x square is equals to root 7. So this will be root 7. So you can write here x is equals to root 7. Okay, so you can write here x is equals to 7. Okay, so here, if I'm asking you sine B is 3 by 4. Then what will be the value of sine A? For sine A, you will consider this angle. And for this one, this will be this upon this.
Root 7 by 4.
Root 7 by 4. Okay. So writing this one, you can write here that sine A is actually root 7 by 4. I'm writing here just to explain you something, some new tricks, or you can say that some new properties of the trigonometries. If I'm writing here sine A, dear student, so that is equals to 7 by 4. What is the value of cos B? Tell me, what will be the value of cos B? Cos B. Considering this theta, what will be the value of cos B? So here it will be equivalent to cos b. What will be the value of cos b, dear student? If you consider the b, this will be base, this will be perpendicular. The value of cos b will be base upon hypotenuse. Cos theta is actually base upon hypotenuse. So that will be again cos b is also equals to root 7 by 4. So if I'm saying sine a is equals to 7 by 4, then cos b is also equals to 7 by 4. So we can simply say that sine a is equals to cos b. You can simply write here sine a is equals to cos b. Dear student, got it? Got it?
Yes, sir.
And in the similar way, you can write here sine b is equals to cos a. Okay, got it? Got it? So eliminate one thing here from here. Eliminate one thing. If I'm writing this one as cos sine a, so in term of a, what will be the value of this one? In term of a. It will be sine b is equals to cos a. Simple, dear student. In term of a, eliminate one. Means if it is being written here in such type of problem, when you will be solving such type of problem, what you need to do is that you need to make the theta same. If it is a, then try to make all a. So it will be more easier for you to solve. Okay. So otherwise you can take the LCM also, or you can do anything. Okay. So if I'm writing to your student here that this one is sine b, so I can write, instead of sine b, I can also write here cos a, because sine b is equals to cos a. So similarly, sine a is also equals to cos b. So you can write like this way. Okay, so dear student, you can write here sine a upon cos b plus, sorry, sine a upon, here it is b, it is being written b here. So in terms of b, if you need to replace in terms of a, so what will be the value of, in terms of a, what will be the value of sine b? What will be the value of sine b in terms of a? That will be cos a. Sine b is equals to cos a. Got it? Or is still having some doubt? Do you understood this one? Let me know first.
Yes.
Yeah, I will explain you again. Dear student, just listen to me. That we have predicted that this one is, the value of sine a is 7 by 4. This one is 7 by 4. How we predict sine a is 7 by 4? For a, this theta will be considered, and the value of sine is actually perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So this one is perpendicular and this one is hypotenuse. This comes this one. And for this same question, we find that cos b, if I'm considering this as b, so this will be considered as perpendicular, this will be considered as base, and this will be, this is hypotenuse common for all. Okay, so here the value of cos is actually base upon hypotenuse, and for b, this will be considered as base. So this will be root 7 upon 4. So root 7 upon 4, this is cos b. So I can simply write here that sine a is actually equals to cos b, that we have proved, that is 7 upon 4. And in the similar way, cos b will be equals to cos a. Sorry, sine b will be equals to cos a. Means sine a is equals to cos b. Cos a is equals to sine b. If there is a in sine, then it will be equals to cos with b. Sine can be equal to cos if a, and you have seen this one. Okay, so we have done this one here also, that sine a is equals to cos b. If I'm writing here sine b, the sine b will be equals to cos a. So this is the reciprocal. Okay, so if I ask you to predict this value, if sine b is only given to you, then what will be the value of this one? One is just you write the value of each, sine a, sine b, cos a, cos b. Other step is just to simplify this one. First simplify this one and then solve the problem. There may be chances where you can commit the mistake, dear student. There may be chances where you can commit the mistake if you write the value of individual, like sine a upon then the value of sine b, then cos b, then sine a, cos a. So there may be chances that you can commit some mistake. But if you simplify this one first, then there will be one term at the end you will get, and that will, you can easily find out the value of that term. So here you write there that sine A, then what will be the value of in terms of sine, what will be the value of sine B in terms of A? Means theta, you need A. That will be equivalent to cos A. Got it?
Yes,
got
sir.
It here, student? Got it?
Yes,
clear? Okay. In the similar way, I'm writing here cos B. What will be the value of, why? Because there is cos A and there is also cos A. So let the denominator be same. So change this one in terms of A. Change this one in terms of A. What will be the value of this one in terms of A? That will be sine A, because cos B is equal to sine A, and that is already written here, that is cos A. Okay, so sine upon cos, I have taught you that what is the value of sine upon cos. If the theta is same, dear student, just keep in mind one thing here, that if I'm saying sine theta upon cos theta is equal to tan theta, that I have taught you. We were discussing this one, we have proved this one also. So if I'm saying this sine theta upon cos theta is equal to tan theta, so you need to keep in mind that the theta must be same for both cos and sine. If I'm writing like this way, sine A upon cos B, so that cannot be equal to tan A or tan B. That cannot be equal. Here A in both of them, A must be same. Okay. So here I found that sine A upon cos A, and this, there I found again sine A upon cos A. So you can take the simple sine upon sine A, you can write it like this way, or you can write this one, this is tan A and this one is tan A. So you can write here tan A plus tan A, and that will be equals to 2 tan A, because A is same here, A is same here. Okay, sine upon cos A, A is same. So you can write here tan A, 2 tan A. Okay, so tan A, in terms of A, you need to find out in terms of 2 into tan A. So what will be the value of 2 into tan A? So actually you have find that 10 is in terms of A, that is 7 upon root 7 upon 3. So you can write here root 7 upon 3, that is perpendicular upon base. So that is root 7 upon 3. That will be 2 root 7 upon 3 will be the answer. Got it, dear student? Got it? It's so simple. If you know that how to change the things accordingly, then it will be simple and easy for you, that you can easily solve such type of problems. If you know the concept clearly, that how this term can be changed into one, from one to another form, that is clear. Okay, so is that clear to you, dear student, or still having some doubt? Let me know, is that clear to you or still having some doubt?
Clear,
so please copy this one. Tanishka and Biju, because Sadhna is not studying science. So Sadhna and Biju and all of you, you can all three can ask for the notes. If you want the notes of that is human eye in the colorful words, so please mail me. I have in the previous class, I have also discussed that. Please mail me at avesarsh@gmail.com. So that I can send you the mail. So then I can send you the notes of human eye in the colorful world, or other chapters also that I have taught also as the PPT will, I can send you. There are so many things that I need to send you. So I need your mail address. If you mail me for the ones, then next time I will send you, and I will inform you that I have sent you the notes. Please, I have sent you the assessment. I have sent you the assignments. So please solve that one. So please note it down. It's my mail ID, AVESARSH tanishka@gmail.com. Please send a single or ask for the notes, right? I'm Tanishka and I need the notes first. Then I will be able to send you. Okay. So please, for that, because that chapter is important, but you need to study one time thoroughly through the notes. That is very simple notes, and that is written in a very simple language. If you read it, and then I will explain you that how this phenomena, natural phenomena, is going to happen, then you will be able to understood the nature about these phenomena. Or human eye and the clerical, what is you can easily, it can be easily prepared, because the main portion, that is the working of eye, is not in our syllabus in this this time. So that need the teacher assistant actually. So I want you to please mail me, so that I can in the next class I can explain you the human eye and the colorful word, and we'll practice the numerical of the ninth chapter. Okay, so done this one. Both of you, three of you, done.
Yes.
Biju, you also.
Yes, sir.
Anishka, Biju, Sadhana, all done. Chalo. Let's move to the next type of questions. So this type of simple questions comes to your examination, that you can simply do. That's not a big deal. Okay, you can easily solve this type of problem. Let's move to the next. We will also solve the questions also, but first we need to learn that how the type of questions comes in your examinations. Then we will practice. First we are learning the art that how to solve it, go through the questions and how to do them. And if once we learn that one, then we will be able to solve the types of problems. Any problem that comes, then we will be able to solve. Okay. So first, let's move to the questions first. Another type of question that comes in your examination is you will be given in the form of a square, like 4 power minus cos square power. And you need to prove this one, that this one is this. Now we are moving toward the trigonometric identities. Okay. And for these, for solving these, we need to learn here that we have the some identity that I have written, and I have ask you to write in your notebook. One is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. The second one is 1 plus 10 square theta is equals to sec square theta. Another one is 1 plus cot square theta is equals to cosec square theta. And the one is, last one is 10 theta is equals to sine theta upon cos theta. Okay. These are the importance, and we will be going to, I mean, we need these to be learned properly so that we can manage and go through such type of problems. So the one type of problem that we face in the examination is we will be going to have the power 4 values, means there will be the question that is going to have the 4 power values, and we have only square, like this one is going to have a square, this one is going to have square. So we don't have the value that is going to have power greater than 2. So what we need to do in such type of problem, we need to make them we simplify them and make them in the form of power 2. So we write here sine square theta whole square, then cos square theta whole square. This is our first priority, that we will change the power 4 into the square form. So how the power 4, if someone is having power, like a is square having power 4. So how can I write this one? I can simply write this one a square raised to the power 2. So if I write this one, so you see that here in this step, I find that this will become a. If sine square is my a and cos square is my b, so I can write here a square minus b square. Means here the value of a is actually sine square theta, and the value of cos b is actually cos square theta, dear student. Okay, so you can simply write here that the sine square theta minus cos square theta is our identity. First a plus b and a minus b. Got it till here? Tell me, let me know. Got it? Or still having some doubt? No, dear student.
Please repeat.
Okay. So, dear student, now I'm going to teach you, what I'm teaching you right now is that how we are going to face the problems in the examinations, and how many types of problems does we usually have, and for that, how can we deal with such type of problems? There are some steps that help us to solve the problems. The first type of problem that we usually have in our examination is that we will be going to have the power 4, like cos square power 4, sine square power 4, tan square power 4. So whenever we are going to have this power 4, first step is just to bring them and or convert it into the square form. So if it is being written like this, sine is square, sine power 4, sine 4, sine raised to the power 4 theta. Okay. So how can you convert this one? So you can write this sine square theta whole square, right? Like you can write it like this way. Will you be able to write this one or not? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Will you be able to write this one? Yes, you can write this one. Okay. So after writing this one, you can write this one like this way. One sine square theta whole square minus cos square theta. Okay. Okay. Then what will happen here is that sine square theta minus cos square theta is equals to sine theta. Means this one is actually our A, this one is actually our B, and A is going to have the whole square and B is also going to have the whole square. So what is the value of A squared, A minus B, A square theta, sorry, A square minus B square, that is A plus B and A minus B. A plus B and A minus B. So you can simply write here that, you can simply write here that 1 plus sine square theta minus cos square theta is equals to this one. Okay, you can simply write this one like this one. Okay, got it?
Yes.
Any, you have to write A plus B. What is A? A is actually sine square theta and B is actually cos square theta. So sine square theta minus cos square theta, sine square theta plus cos square theta. And I have taught you that the value of this one is actually 1. So you can write there the value of this one is 1. Now the remaining, when 1 is multiplying by any number, this will be like this one. So how can you have to bring this one. Now you have to keep in mind that what you need to bring. You can further divide this one. You can further divide this one like sine theta plus cos theta bracket sine theta minus cos theta minus cos theta. You can go through this step also. This is now if you consider sine theta as a whole square, sine square theta can be written as sine theta whole square minus cos square theta can be written as cos theta whole square. So it can be further written like this way. But you need to keep in mind, no, we are not going to lose the square now because we need the square in our answer. We need square in our answer. So no need to solve it further by using the identity A square minus B square. So we use this one. Now no need to split this further. Leave it like this way. Now what you need to do is that you don't need the cos in your answer. You don't need the cos in your answer. Cos theta you don't require. Why? Because here if we are having the cos and in our answer, there is no cos. So we need to eliminate the cos first because it is not in our use. So what is the value of cos square theta in terms of sine? Because we need the sine. And what's the value of cos in terms of sine? So cos in terms of sine, cos in terms of sine. So you will learn that which identity can give you this answer, which identity will help you to solve this answer. So you can simply solve this one by writing that you can write this one that cos theta will be equals to 1 minus sine square theta when this sine goes to that side. But actually you need the value of cos square theta. So write this minus sign here and the value of cos square theta will be 1 minus sine square theta, 1 minus sine square theta because sine will go to that side. Now simply dear student, you need to keep in mind that you have written this one. Now open the bracket with this minus sign. When this minus sign is being multiplied with this minus one, you will get minus one. And when this minus sign is being multiplied with this minus sine theta, it will be positive sine theta. Got it till here? You understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Pakka? Confirm? Biju? Got it, dear student. So please copy this one and then with sine theta will be added and this will give you minus one. So what this type of question is about, whenever we are going to have the value in 4, then that time, dear student, you need to keep in mind that you need to split in terms of square because we don't have any identity that is going to have in power 4. Got it? So copy this one fast as soon as possible. That's all for today. We'll be going to study in the next class some other topics. It means this topic will be continued. And please do not miss the next class because in the next class, we'll be going to discuss that. In the next class, we'll be going to discuss that what are the other types of problems that we'll be going to have while solving the trigonometric identities or trigonometric problems. So please do not miss that class, because if you miss that class, you don't need my assistant, then you have to see the video. So please, that will be more easier for you, that will be continuous. Okay, so please copy this one. Copy it. Copy, dear student.
No, sir, 1 minute.
Okay, please copy this one. Done.
Yes.
Okay. So that's all for